for Unity as he accepts his new role as one of the most powerful men on Earth.
Now it's time for America to bind the wounds of division. Have to get together. To all Republicans and Democrats and independents across this nation, I say it is time for us to come together as one united people.
His team is already working on his agenda for his first 100 days in office, and tomorrow he has been invited to meet with President Obama at the White House to work out the transition of power. Let's go now to CNN's MJ Lee, who is outside Trump Tower there in New York. What do we know so far as a transition with the president-elect?
Well, Brooke, Donald Trump was elected last night, but those transition efforts are already well underway. I think symbolically, that really started a couple of hours ago when we heard President Obama speak from the White House and essentially said that he wanted to make sure that there was a smooth transition of power. And as you mentioned, the current president, President Obama, and now President-elect Donald Trump will meet at the White House to begin that process officially. And Donald Trump is also getting underway in the transition process and has a lot of work to do. And starting today, we know from a senior administration official that Donald Trump will begin to get daily, highly classified briefings. And in those briefings, Brooke, he will be, given information that only the president currently is briefed on at such a high level. So that process has already begun. And also, we know that the State Department is fully ready to start briefing the transition team. So that's another thing to watch out for as well. And of course, the other big question is, how will Donald Trump begin to fill out his administration, fill out some of those key posts, including in the cabinet, on some names that have already begun to float out there for the role of chief of staff, include Chris Christie, Rudy Giuliani, Reince Priebus, and Newt Gingrich. Now, Brooke, before I go, I do want to just quickly set the scene. I am across the street from Trump Tower, and there are road closures all down Fifth Avenue, creating really a bottleneck, and a ton of people still outside taking photos of Trump Tower, this building that has become really an iconic landmark during this election. I can imagine that this sort of a scene is going to be the new normal here as Donald Trump spends the next 2 months beginning his preparations to move to Washington, D.C. Brooke.
It's become a new sort of tourist stop along Fifth Avenue, and Thanksgiving around the corner. That's going to be quite the spot in a couple of weeks. MJ in New York, thank you so much. During the final stretch of this campaign, Donald Trump's unfavorable rating actually hit 60%. Only 8% of voters who said they valued experience supported him over Hillary Clinton. So, let's go to David Chalian, our CNN political director, who was up in the wee hours of the morning, who is with us now this afternoon to explain. I mean, we talked about Brexit for so long.